श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं देवी शारदे ज्ञानप्रदे ज्ञानेश्वरी ज्ञानवाहिनी ज्ञानकोशं समुद्घाटय ज्ञानसुधां सदा वर्षय अंतर्ज्योतिर्बहिर्ज्योतिः प्रत्यग्ज्योतिः परात्परः ज्योतिर्ज्योतिर्स्वयं ज्योतिः आत्मज्योतिःशिवोऽस्मि अहम् हरिः ॐ तत्सत्।
नमस्ते। Our Sanatana Dharma is a finely tuned web of culture, customs, traditions, fine arts, literature being rich with jnana. Sanatana Dharma is jnana kosha, rich treasury of knowledge. Our Guru Parampara, it is a sturdy boat of knowledge, jnana nauka, starting from Sadashiva all the way to the present Guru, Asmadacharya Paryanta. It is sailing on the river of knowledge, Jnana Vahini. This Jnana Nauka is carrying all the gurus, rishis, munis, and darshanikas. This boat is led by Jnaneshwari Sharade, who is magnetically attracting all Jivatmas by sprinkling Jnana Sudha, the nectar of knowledge. Jnana is immortal Amrita. It is sweet and nourishing like Sudha. This Jnana Sudha is essential to every Jivatma to realize the supreme truth, Brahma Satya. With the blessings of Sharadamba and our Sringeri Sri Jagadgurus, SVBF is having the vision of conducting Jnana Sudha as an ongoing Satsangha with scholars, revered Swamijis of various ashramas, artists of various fine arts sharing their knowledge. Let us take part in sipping this Jnana Sudha to become a real good human being and to grow as divine being.
Shruti Smriti Puranana
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. On behalf of SVBF Canada, pleasure to welcome our special artists and all of you for today's special Jnana Sudha program. Adi Shankara's compositions unparalleled in Sanatana Dharma literature. His bhakti and their expressions take us from common human beings to a life with some meanings. Adi Shankaracharya's stotras are a combination of poetic beauty and devotion. Stotras of this caliber are the outburst of divine inspiration unsurpassed by any ordinary human beings. Dr. Alakananda and Dr. Suyamurthy have conceptualized today's program on Adi Shankara's stotras. Now, just a few words about our artists. Dr. Alakananda Nath has a unique combination of expertise in Bharatanatyam, Carnatic music, and Sanskrit literature. She has been performing and imparting these fine arts by keeping bhakti as the primary and pivotal incentive. She has composed philosophical and soul touching music, as well as lyrics in Sanskrit and Kannada for our dance dramas and dance music. Her passionate lectures on scriptures and philosophical texts have impacted many in their spiritual quest. A warm welcome to Dr. Alkananda. Now, a word about Dr. Sriya Murthy. She has been trained under her guru and mother, Dr. Alkananda of Kalakshetra, Chennai, with a focus on geometric aesthetics and bhakti. Her solo performance, Nrityangana, encompassing the theoretical topics of dance in a nutshell, was well received both in Toronto and Kalakshetra itself. Another noteworthy performance of Sriya was Radhe Krishna, based on Gita Govinda, with the well-researched insight into the spiritual aspects of bridal mysticism. During her doctorate studies, Sriya was the president of Cambridge University, UK, Indian Classical Arts Society. A warm welcome to Dr. Sriya Murthy as well.
कोशं समुद्घाटय ज्ञान सुधां सदा
Varshaya.
Namaste. Talking about Shankaracharya, he is like attempting to climb Kailasa Parvata. At the most, one can just go around doing the parikrama at the very foot of Kailasa Parvata. In the same way, one can only fall at the feet of Shankaracharya, like an ant at a time takes one grain of sugar, it enjoys, and it collects the grains of sugar to the rainy season one by one. In the same way, if we are able to even understand and go deep into even one stotra of Shankaracharya, it will benefit, it will help us, it will guide us all the way till we reach the soul, Atman, Brahman. His stotras have that great power, mantric power in them. And Shankaracharya is Sarvajna. That is, he is all in all. Shankaracharya, he is Sarvajna in the sense that he is knowledgeable in all faculties of sciences. He is expert in sciences like Tarka, Nyaya, Mimamsa, and Himalayan tradition of mysticism. And he is deeply involved in karma, bhakti, and jnana. And thus, he is like Brahman, all-pervading Brahman, is very much pervading every atom of the whole manifestation. In the same way, Shankaracharya is into all sciences, Sarvajna. And he pervades into every atom, every portion of all sciences. And yet he is beyond like the Brahman. And thus, it is very, very wrong to put Shankaracharya into any one box, into any one science, saying he is a Vedantin, he is a mystic, he is a jnani, he is a bhakta, he is everything. He is into all faculties. Whatever is constantly happening in the whole manifestation is happening within Brahman, within Brahman. The stotras are coming from Shankaracharya like the fountain. It rises up. It rises up. It originates from Brahman. And it takes different emotions, heightened bhakti,
devotion, and thus he is Bhakta Shiromani as well. And his stotras are filled with Vedantic injunctions as well. So, it is the greatness of Shankaracharya, uniqueness is that he is genius in binding, connecting the form with the formless, tradition with imagination, and ritualistic puja vidhi, worship, with adhyatma in his stotras. So the same stotra caters to all devotees of different levels in their understanding and in their spiritual progress. Today, I'm only attempting to highlight few points about 4 or 5 shlokas, stotras, which will give us just a peep into what each stotra is offering to us. Let me take Bhavani Ashtakam as the first item. Bhavani Ashtakam highlights Sharanagati, total surrender, which is very much needed to lead the life peacefully in this physical world and also to proceed further in our spiritual quest. It is Bhavani Ashtakam which shows how the human being, Jivatma, struggles at each situation in relationships, going after the objects and getting caught in it, and how to come out of it. It guides us, it tells us the fact that it is Bhavani alone who can protect us at every situation which we face in life. Surrendering to Bhavani comes only when one has the jnana that it is Bhavani alone who can help us, who can guide us, and how to come out of the tag that I am Jivatma, I am Jivatma. So, why Shankaracharya is talking about Bhavani? Who is Bhavani? Bhavani is Adi Parashakti, the primordial, active, powerful consciousness, who is taking care of Srishti, Sthiti, Laya of the whole Vishwa, as well as every Jivatma. As Bhava Ani, Bhavani, Bhava Ani. She infuses life to all Jivatmas. As Bhavani, the wife of Shiva, as mother, she protects us, Sthiti, in this world. As Bhava Ni, she is the one who makes us cross over the ocean of samsara. So, in this stotra, Bhavani Ashtaka, it echoes how Jnani like Shankaracharya is realizing the truth behind Vishwa, the whole world, and every Jivatma. And he is pleading with Bhavani, O Ma Bhavani, Gatistvam, gatistvam, tvameka bhavani. You are the refuge. You are the lone refuge whom I want to resort to. When I am caught in so many situations in life, when I am filled with ignorance and I am limiting myself as a jivatma, I go through so many different situations in life that I am unable to come out of it. You are the one who can protect me, O Ma Bhavani. So, intellectually understanding this, the whole universe is transient and it is illusory in its nature, will not help us. The scriptures can tell us, but unless we make it part of our life, it's not going to help us. So this Bhavani Ashtaka, when we keep repeating it again and again, it makes us go deeper and deeper into finding what the truth is, how one can surrender to Bhavani and come out of the situations. So I request Sviya to
तातो न माता न बंधु न दाता न पुत्रो न पुत्री न भृत्यो न भत्ता न जाया न विद्या न वृत्ति भीरु प्रपात प्रकामी प्रलोभी प्रमत्थ कुसंसार पाश प्रबद्ध सदा गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं ममेका भवानी गतिस्त्वं भवामि न जानामि दानं न च ध्यानयोगं न जानामि तन्त्रं न च स्तोत्रमन्त्रं न जानामि पूजां न च न्यासयोगं गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानी गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानी गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानी न जानामि पुण्यं न जानामि तीर्थं न जानामि मुक्तिं लयं वा कराचित् न जानामि भक्तिं व्रतं वापि माधन् गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि कुकर्मी कुसङ्गी कुबुद्धि कुदास कुलाचारहीन कदाचारलीन कुदृष्टि कुवाक्य प्रबन्ध सदा गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानी गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानी गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानी प्रजेशं रमेशं महेशं सुदेशं दिनेशं निशीथेश्वरं वा कदाचित् न जानामि चान्यत् सदाहं शरण्ये गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि विवादे विषादे प्रमादे प्रभाते जले चानले पर्वते शत्रुमध्ये अरण्ये शरण्ये सदा मां प्रवाहि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि अनाथो दरिद्रो जरारोगयुक्तो महाक्षीणदीनः सदा जाढ्यवक्त्रः विपत्तो प्रविष्टः प्रनष्टः सदाहं गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं त्वमेका भवानि
So next let us move on to Vishnu Shatpadi, which is a deep prayer, prarthana,
to Lord Vishnu Narayana. This stotram is with simple adjectives, different names of Lord Narayana. Even though the words are very, very simple, the way he has selected the words make it a very unique stotra, which has so many secrets of Vedantic views. Deep devotion to Narayana to take away the fear, agony, anxiety, and the sorrow which every Jivatma goes through. Avinaya mapanaya Vishnu damaya manashamaya vishaya mrita Krishna. O Narayana Vishnu, drive away my immodesty, arrogance. Make my mind suppressed and controlled towards the tendencies towards the greedy desires of the worldly pleasures, which are nothing but like the mirage. They are all illusory and I am running behind it. Please make me be filled with gratitude instead of that arrogance. Bhutadayam vistaraya karaya samsara sagaratah. Bhutadayam vistaraya. Please expand the compassion towards all beings, be it human beings, the animals, the plants, the whole Vishwa, the whole nature. See, in the first stanza itself, Shankaracharya is telling us the main three qualities which a Jivatma needs to be a good human being, to develop as a divine being. Those three are having the gratitude towards the whole world, having the good control over all the five senses which are running behind all the objects of the world, relationships of the world, which are all like mirage. Where there is no water, it looks as though there is lots of water. And then Bhutadaya, compassion towards all beings and the whole Vishwa, will make me a pure-hearted, universal person. So it brings the harmony within and without. And then Divya Dhuni Makarande Parimala Paribhoga Sachidanande Shripati Padaravinde Bhava Bhaya Kheda Chide Vande. See how the divine vision is beautifully, poetically expressed by Shankaracharya. I bow down to Shripati Padaravinda. That is, Shripati is Narayana. His Padaravinda, lotus-like feet, which has the nectar. What is that nectar? It is the celestial Ganga. Ganga Mai is oozing with so much of compassion. And that is the nectar of Padaravinda. And Parimala, that fragrance which this lotus is showering, emitting, is Sat Chit Ananda, the pure existence consciousness with bliss. Is it a simple fragrance? It is paribhoga, paribhoga, the utmost fragrance. Once we have that fragrance, Satchidananda fragrance, all other worldly fragrances which we are all attracted towards will fall down like anything. And that fragrance, Padaravinda of Shri Pati, is anything for us to enjoy. Most cherishable. And the next one, it gives the Vedantic concept very clearly in such two lines. Satyapi bhedapagame natha tavaham namamakinastvam samudrohi tarangah kvachana samudro natarangah. In spite of reality being, there is no difference between you and me. Yet, I belong to you, whereas you don't belong to me. You're all pervading. How can I contain you? But I am yours. I am in you. Just like there is no difference between the waves and the ocean. Both are water. Yet, what wave belongs to the ocean, but ocean does not belong to the wave. So, here the point is, one should not, as long as we are clinging to the tag that I am the Jivatma, I can never claim that Paramatma being contained in me. And then the poetic exuberance still goes further. In the next, he uses Mukta Pada Grastha. It is a kind of alankara in which the last portion of the previous word rolls to the next one and then to the next one. Listen to this. Udhrita naga naga bidanuja danuja kula mitra mitra shashi drishte drishte bhavati prabhavati na bhavati kim bhavati raskarah matsyadi bhiravatarai ravataravatavata sadavasudham parameshwara paripalyo bhavata bhavata pabhitoham. So here he is also showing his great knowledge in Purana. He is Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam. He is well versed in all Shruti, Smriti and Purana. So here he is using Udhruta Naga Nagabhidanuja. Udhruta Naga is lifting the mountain, Govardhana mountain, with his little finger, where he is Vishnu, Krishna, and Indra is the opponent, enemy. In the next word, Naghabit Anuja, he becomes, Vishnu becomes the brother of Indra when Vishnu is in the avatara of Vamana. So he's also called Upendra, because Indra was the brother of Vamana. So see how he has used both the Purana stories next to next, but they are connected. Udhruta Naga Nagabhidanuja. So here in the first one, they are enemies. In the second one, they are brothers. So what does it mean? The relationships are always superimposed. It is not eternal or it is not permanent. And then when we go to the next one, Damodara Gunamandira Sundara Vadanaravinda Govinda Bhavajaladhi Matana Mandara Paramam Dharamapanaya Tvam Me. Damodara, it refers to Krishna when he was Balakrishna. Yashoda had tied him up with the rope. So that Krishna is called Damodara. So in a way it is telling, oh Narayana, even though you were roped, you were bound, you were subjugated, you were dominated by Yashoda Mai, yet your greatness is so much that you are like the mountain to a Jivatma who is getting churned in the ocean of samsara, this world. So what do we mean by that? Bhava jaladhi mathana mandara. Mandara parvata is so huge. When a jiva is caught in the water of the oceans, at least if the ocean allows us to float, somehow we can manage and breathe. But here, the ocean of samsara is churning us. There is no way I can breathe, come out. So at that moment of a jivatma, what is the most needed thing? It is a piece of land so that I can stand on that and breathe. So for that, Narayana is not coming in the form of a leaf or a small log, wooden log, but he is coming there. He is appearing as Mandara Parvata. So the devotee can just be there with Narayana, such a huge Parvata where I can just land safely. Narayana Karunamaya Sharanam Karavani Tavakau Charanam Iti Shatpadi Madiye Vadana Saroje Sada Vasatu. Oh compassionate Narayana, let me resort to your 2 feet as my refuge. May this Shatpadi Vasatu Sada Vasatu, let this Shatpadi be in my Vadana Saroja, in the lotus-like face of mine all the time. Here we have to see the 2 words which are really unlocking like the key to our spiritual progress, which are those 2 words, Shatpadi and Madiye Vadana Saroja. These are the 2 words. Shatpadi has so many meanings to it. Shat is number 6. Padi is feet. One who has the 6 feet is a bee. It can be bumblebee or honeybee. It is a bee which always hovers around a flower which has lots of makaranda, the nectar in it, which has sweet fragrance in it. That is one. This whole stotra is like the Shatpadi, which has 6 verses. Not only that, Narayana Karunamaya Sharanam Karavani Tavakau Charanam. There are 6 words in this one line. And Shankaracharya is calling this line as Shatpadi. And another meaning for Shatpadi is, a human being has 5 senses plus 1 mind as 6 feet. So he refers to all Jivatmas as Shatpadi. Now if you take the meaning of all these things, we can understand why he has said Madiye Vadana Saroje. Vadana Saroja, the lotus-like face, lotus-like mouth. We say it normally for Bhagavan. But here, Shankaracharya is telling, in my lotus-like face, on what basis? This is where we need to do the contemplation on the meaning, and we can go deeper and deeper into it, which will lead us to know the Upanishadic Vedantic injunction. So let me show how a sadhaka can go deeper and deeper into it. When it says Vadana Saroja, this face has all the five senses in it, and the mind also is represented in this face. And only if I use all the five and the mind to reverberate all the time with Narayana Karunamaya Sharanam Karavani Tavakau Charanam, whatever I see as the feet of Narayana, whatever fragrance I am experiencing, that also as coming from the lotus feet of Narayana. Like that, if everything is reverberating Narayana, Narayana, Padaravinda, naturally, automatically, my face will become Saroja. It will become Kamala, the lotus. So, what is it saying? Bhagavan's face is also Vadana Saroja. My face is also Vadana Saroja. So it is leading me to know that it is Bimba Pratibimba concept. And the reflection of Narayana. So if I have to be the reflection of Narayana, if his face is Vadana Saroja, I have to make my face also Vadana Saroja by making every sense organ which is there in the face reverberating the line Narayana Karunamaya Sharanam Karavani Tavakau Charanam. Oh, compassionate Narayana, let me resort to your lotus feet as my refuge. That should stay in our mind and the five senses. Then I will be the perfect reflection of Narayana, who is Vadana Saroja. So,
Vishnu
tamaya manha shamaya vishaya jagat krishna bhutadaya vistaraya taraya samsara sagaratah Divya Dhuni Makarande Parimala Paribhoga Satchidanande Shri Padi Padaravihande Bhava Bhaya Kheda Kide Satyapi Dhedapagame Natha Savaham Namamati Nastvam Samudrohitarangah Svachana Samudro na saranga Udhrata naga naga bhidanuja Danuja kula mitra Mitra shashi drishti Drishti bhavati prabhavati na bhavati Kim Bhavati Raskarah Matsyadi Bhiravatarai Avataravatasata Sada Vasudha Parameshwara Paripayo Bhavata Bhavatapa Dito Damodara Gunamandira Sundara Vadana Ravinda Go Mandara Paramam Dharam Apanaya Vamne Narayana Karunamaya Narayana Karunamaya Narayana Karunamaya Sharanam Karani Tavakau Charanam Yeti Shatpati Iti Shatpati Iti Shatpati Iti Shatpati Madiye Vadana Saroje Sada Vasatu Narayana Karunamaya Sharanam Karavani Tavakau Charanam Narayana Narayana
let us move on to the next one, Shiva Manasa Puja, which is a real guide to all the sadhakas of different levels. In Tantra Shastra, there are three types of worships. One is external worship called Kaula Marga, where the material is used to do the puja to an idol or a photo or yantra. Another one is Samaya Marga, where the whole worship is happening within the mind. Everything is worship internally, Samaya Marga. And the third one is Mishra Marga, where the worship is having both Kaula Marga as well as Samaya Marga. For example, we say, I am offering different kinds of flowers, but we will be cooking only the Mantrakshate. So that is Mishra Marga. However, Shankaracharya professes, advocates Samaya Marga, which is internal worship. So this Shiva Manasa Puja is a very good base for a sadhaka to climb the ladder of spiritual progress. So Shodashopachara is part of the Tantra Shastra, where 16 levels of worship is offered. Here in this Shiva Manasa Puja, Shiva is worshipped as the first step, having the idol. And when the sadhaka goes to the next level, he will be having the same idol in his mind, and he will be doing the worship in the mind in detail. When he feels one with the Shiva being within, that joy makes him contemplate and keep thinking about Shiva more and more. And thus it becomes contemplative, meditative worship, which converts itself, which transforms itself as upasana, where we are one with Shiva. When this continues, the sadhaka realizes the Atma, which is everywhere, is Shiva, and that Shiva is within me as Atma. And thus, the worship continues in the form of meditation. And even the worship material will also become his own body and his own thought. So today I'm going to express my understanding, my feeling, and my sadhana which has taken me in this Shiva Manasa Puja. So I will be doing it in detail so that you can have the taste of how Shankaracharya takes care of all levels of devotees.
Kailasa Shikhare Ramye Shankarasya Shivalaye Devatastatra Modante Tanvana Shiva Sankalpamastu Ratnai Kalpitam Asanam Himajalaihi Snanam Divya
Sharam
Nana Ratna Vibhushitam Mrigamadamurankitam Chandanam Jati Champakar Bilvapatra Rachitam Pushpam Chadhupam Tathadipam Devadayanidhe Pashupate Hrikalpitam Grihyata Ratnaikalpitam Asanam.
I offer my heart as the seat which shines with thoughts on you like studded gems.
Himajalaihi snanam.
The bliss of deep meditation on Shiva is creating the cool, pleasant chill throughout the body. I am bathing you with Ananda Bashpa, the cool, icy tears of joy constantly rolling down.
Divyambaram.
You being that unlimited, immeasurable Atman, I can only wrap you with my divine, unlimited Chidakasha, ether of consciousness.
Nana Ratna Vibhushitam.
My genuine thoughts on you are shining like various gems with different hues by which I decorate you.
Mrigamadamodankitam Chandanam.
Having grown in the spiritual attainment, a new fragrance of knowledge has been churned out. The fragrance, I offer it to you as my tribute.
Jati Champaka Bilva Patra Rachitam Pushpam Chadhupam Tathadipam.
Having imbibed the virtues of these flowers and Bilva leaves, whatever I perceive as fragrance, the bright forms, I offer it to you as tribute to enjoy bhoga.
Devadayanidhe Pashupate.
Being seated within me as my Atma, O Pashupati, with immense compassion, you are the protector of me, a jiva,
Pasha Baddha Pashu, Hrikalpitam Grihyatam.
My Antahkarana, my Chitta, is the one which is offering this worship as a tribute to Shiva, Chidananda Atma within me.
Sovarni Navaratna Khanda Rachite Patre Ghritam Payasam.
My physical body, Sthula Sharira, is the golden vessel with radiant thoughts on Shiva as studded gems. In that vessel, my meditative mind is like the pure ghee, heated and clarified with contemplation, that is giving rise to immense joy, which I offer as sweet payasam.
Bhakshyam panchavidam payodadhiyutam Ramphapalam Panakam.
I offer the perception through five senses as five kinds of food. I offer the result, phala, of all my Shivamaya thoughts and actions as Rambhapala, the banana fruit. I offer Panakam as Satsanga, studying scriptures, listening to Adhyatma Vichara, Nidhidhyasana, Dhyana, which are all serving as catalyst drink to digest and progress in the spiritual path.
Shatanam Vayutam Jalam Ruchikaram.
I offer tasteful water scented with various fruits, vegetables, and herbs. The flow of life as water mixed with the essence called Shivatva in the experiences of the world has become enjoyable. That I offer to you.
Shatanamayutam Jalam Ruchikaram. Karpurakhandojvalam Tambulam.
I offer Tambula in the form of constant japa of your name, satisfaction of experiencing you within me, and shedding tears of joy.
Manasamaya Virajitam Bhatya Prabho Sri Guru.
O Prabho, my mind is filled with you to such an extent that mind is totally absorbed in praising, adoring you as my own son. Please accept my worship.
Chatram chamarayoryugam vyajanakam chadarshakam malam.
I offer false I, ahankara, as the umbrella. I offer the faculties of memory and intellect as chamara on either side. I offer my spotless clear mind as clean mirror.
Veena bheri mridanga tahala kala geetam chandrityam tatha.
I offer my body as veena, rhythmic physiological actions happening within the body as rhythmic instrument. I offer well-balanced harmony and precise rhythm in body and mind as singing and dancing with immense joy.
Sashthangam pranate sotir bahuvida. Hetat samastam maya sankalpena samarpitam tava vibho pujam grihana prabhu.
Surrendering my antakarana to you, atma within, is my sashthanga pranama. I offer each thought filled with love as stotra for you. Please accept all this as puja vidhi.
Atma tvam girija matihi sahachara prana shariram griham.
O Shiva, you are Atma. Only when there is undivided love for you, Shiva, it is possible to say you are my own Atma. Devi Girija is my buddhi, pure intellect. The Shivaganas, the close associates and attendants, are five vital forces, Pancha Pranas. They are Prana, Apana, Dhyana, Udana, Samana. Here, I would like to share my feelings and the understanding of Ganas. The stereotype, general understanding of Ganas is that Ganas are uneducated, awkward zombies, ugly looking zombies. But my understanding is all these Ganas are with Shiva forever and ever. The constant company of Shiva, because of which they are highly intoxicated with the ananda of that Shivatva. So they are not concerned or connected with this physical world and its customs. So they look different. Like the gopis of Govardhana and Vrindavana, they are all highly experienced, even though they are not well-educated gopis, but they have the divine experience. Like that, even these Ganas, in no way they are lesser than any of the Rishis who have studied the Vedas, because they are well experienced in Shivatva and they're constantly enjoying that intoxication of Ananda. So can you imagine how many Janmas all these Ganas would have experienced to become the Gana? So there is no Shiva without Gana. And there is no Gana without Shiva. Similarly, it is the five motions of air, Vayu, which keeps the body alive and working in synchronization. Atma lives in the body as long as there is Prana.
Ujati Vishayopabhogarachana.
I offer my interactions with this physical world through senses and mind as pujas. While life is experienced as puja vidhi of Shiva, all pleasures and experiences of this world will sublime itself as worship.
Nidhya samadhi sthitihi.
My sleep is the state of samadhi, complete absorption in you, without the trace of I, the individual.
Sancharha padayo pradakshina vidhihi. Stotrani sarva giro.
When mind has totally enveloped Shiva, the body just follows the mind, and thus even the simple walk by feet would turn out as pradakshina. I offer my Shiva-filled thoughts and words as stotras in praise of you.
Yet, yet, karma karomi tat akhilam shambho tava aradhanam.
All my actions, which are in sequence of my mind, and then my thought, and then my words, and then my action would be Shivaradhan.
Karacharana kritam vak sayajam karmajam va shavananayanajam va manasam vaparadham vihitam avihitam va sarvametakshamashva जय जय करुणाभि श्री महादेव शंभो जय जय करुणाभि श्री महादेव शंभो जय जय करुणाभि श्री महादेव शंभो
देन आदि पराशक्ति हरसेल्फ हैज टू टेक सो मेनी लाइफ टू गेट रिड ऑफ द ह्यूमनली ट्रेट्स इमेजिन we jivatmas how much we have to surrender to Shiva to come out of that tag and jivatman and the body and the mind to come out of that how much surrender we have to do for that this Shiva manasa puja certainly helps us Now from this, let us go to the next one, Dakshina Murti Ashtaka. This Ashtaka is on Dakshina Murti, which is the essence of Upanishads in a capsule form. It is a miniature comprised Brahma Sutra itself. It blows off the wrong notions which we all jivatmas. Strongly hold on to and the body and the mind and the limited individual in this universe. I am the victim of kala, desha, karya, karana, bhava. So this ashtakam blows off these notions and it gives the guidance step by step to understand tat tvam asi you are indeed brahman so brahma sutra is in the capsule form as sutra next comes the bhashya which gives the detailed commentary And then comes the prakarana, taking one topic, it gives the details about that topic, and then comes this stotra. The beauty of this Dakshinamurti Ashtaka is, Shankaracharya himself says, "Amush means tave." At the last verse in this stotra, he says. However. Because it is dealing with tat tvam asi the upanishadic aphorism injunction it is enjoying the status as prakarana and even though there are only 10 verses in number the commentaries by great sages rishis like sureshwaracharya goes to volumes and volumes so you can well imagine what is hidden in this Dakshinamurti Ashtaka so because of the time limitation I will take just few verses to give you just the peak of what Shankaracharya is teaching
विश्वं दर्पण दृश्यमान नगरी तुल्यं निजांतर्गतं पश्यन्नात्मनि मायया बहिरिवोद्भूतं यथा निद्रया यः साक्षात् कुरुते प्रबोधसमये स्वात्मानं एव द्वयम् तस्मै श्रीगुरुमूर्तये नमः दक्षिणामूर्तये. The entire world is like a reflected city seen within a mirror. That reflected world is very much within one's own being. But I experience that world as though it is outside. How? It is by the creative power of Maya. The world is illusorily projected outside, like in the dream, where the whole dream world is happening within, but experienced as though it is outside. Once woken up from the dream, one realizes the dreamer, the dream world, and the dream experience were all within oneself. Similarly, once spiritually awakened, one experiences directly the non-dual expanse of one's own Atman, playing as this world, Jagat. Salutations to that personification of our inner Guru, Sri Dakshinamurti, who awakens the glory of Atma within. Bijasyantari vankuro jagadidam pranam nirvikalpam punah maya desha kala kalana vaichitrya chitrikritam maya viva vijrambhayatyapi mahayogi vatya svetthaya तस्मै श्री गुरुमूर्तये नमैदम् श्री दक्षिणामूर्तये. द सीड हैज येट द अनमैनिफेस्टेड सैपलिंग plant and tree with fruits within. Similarly, unmanifest Brahman had the whole universe within. When Maya, the power of creation and illusion, brought in a relationship for that unmanifest Brahman with space and time, the colorful world of multiplicity manifested, unfurled like the play of a great magician a great yogi out of his own free will. Yasyaiva sphuranam sadatmakam asatsalpārthagam bhāsate sākṣāt tat tvam asīti vedavajasa yo bodhayatyāśritam yat sākṣāt karanāt bhavena punaravrastir bhavambho nidham tasmai shri guru murtaye namaidam shri dakshina murtaye. Brahman, the existence, awareness, absolute, alone pervades all objects of the world. Brahman makes them shine, become evident by imparting its own reality to them, which are themselves unreal. Tat Tvam Asi, that Brahman indeed is you, the Atman. This is the teaching of the Lord Dakshinamurti in the form of words of Veda to his devotees. Whoever realizes this truth will not return to the ocean of births and deaths. Nana chidra ghato darastita mahadipa prabha bhaswaram jnanam yasyatu chakshuradi karanadvara bahispandate janamiti tameva bhantam anubhatyetat samastam jagat tasmai shri guru murtaye namaidam shri dakshina murtaye. How does Brahman as Jivatma perceive the objects of the world? When a pot with many holes has a brilliant lamp inside, the light shines through the holes. Similarly, the awareness of Brahman as brilliant light of consciousness, Atma Jyoti, radiates through Jivatma. Further, as chain, one after another, the reflected light passes from aham to buddhi to manas and finally through sense organs, reach out to the objects of the world. The mind receives the mold of the object and sends signal to buddhi and then to aham. That is when Jivatma says, yes, I saw, I heard. Bhuram bhamsya lalo anilombaram ahanatho himamshu poman etya bhati chara chara yasyaivamutyashtakam nanyaskinchana vidyate vimrishatam yasmat parasmat vibho tasmai shri guru murtaye
श्री दक्षिणामूर्तये.
How is Brahman's presence in this world experienced? Brahman as Ishvara has manifested in 8 forms as earth, water, fire, air, space, sun, moon, and Jiva, encompassing the whole world in which there are both moving and non-moving things. For a person with sharp discrimination, apart from Ishvara, Atman, nothing else exists. Whole manifestation is Ishvara. He discovers Ishvara as the essence from which everything originates. Salutations to that personification of our inner Guru, Sri Dakshinamurti, who awakens the glory of Atma within. Theoretically, we understand the Vedantic concepts described in Ashtakam. But how to put it into the practice? How to come out of the tag, and the limited Jivatma? Nirvana Ashtaka is the answer, in which Shankaracharya guides us. I am not this, I am not that, I am not this, I am not that. Layer by layer, he takes away the notions which we are all living so strongly. And this Nirvana Ashtaka, when contemplated, it leads us to understand Chidananda Rupa Shivoham, and that Shiva, who is Chidananda Rupa, who has Chit, the consciousness which is blissful, as Swarupam. So this Nirvana Ashtaka again guides that all kinds of Jivatmas who are in different levels, because one can go layer by layer taking the meaning and go within and see the difference. In the very first one, Bhavani Ashtakam, the core line was Gatistvam, Gatistvam, Tvameka Bhavani. It was the surrender, total Sharanagati. In this Nirvana Shataka, the core line is Chidananda Rupa Shivoham, Shivoham. The Advaita Bhava, which the sadhaka is experiencing. So, Shankaracharya's stotras are unique. It is so powerful that it is catering to all Jivatmas who are all in different levels of spiritual growth. And thus, my koti 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 pranamas to Shankaracharya, who has accepted all of us as his disciple and giving us the chance to grow spiritually. Soham, who am I? Kuta ayatah, from where did I come? Kame janani, who is my mother? Kome tatah, who is my father? Koham, koham,
Om.
मनोबुद्ध्यहंकार चित्तानि नाहं न च श्रोत्रजिह्वे न च घ्राणनेत्र न च व्योमभूमे न तेजो न वायु चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं न च प्राणसंयो न वै पञ्चवायु न वा सप्तधातु न वा पञ्चकोश न वा पाणिपादं न चोपस्थपायु चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं न मे द्वेषरागौ न मे लोभमोहौ मदो नैव मे नैव मात्सर्यभाव न धर्मो न चाथो न कामो न मोक्ष चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं न पापं न सौख्यं न दुःखं न मन्त्रो न तीर्थं न वेदानयज्ञ अहं भोजनं नैव भोज्यं न भोक्ता चिरानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिरानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं न मे मृत्युशङ्का न मे जातिभेदः पिता नैव मे नैव माता न जन्म न बन्धुर्न मेत्रं गुरुर्नैव शेष चिरानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिरानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं अहं निर्विकल्पो निराकाररूपो विभुस्त्वाच्च सर्वत्र सर्वेन्द्रियाणं न चासङ्गतं नैव मूर्तिर्न मेय चिरानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिरानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं शिवोऽहं चिदानन्दरूप शिवोऽहं 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 ओऽहं शिवोऽहं 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 शिवो
It is now time to say thank you but I feel my vocabulary is so inadequate to describe what an incredible treat today's satsanga has been. It was Karanandakara and Nayana Manohara. It is an honor and privilege for me to convey our deepest thanks on behalf of all devotees who are in the temple today and who have joined us via SVBF social media platforms. As many of us know, Dr. Alakananda and Dr. Sriyamurthy, they are mother and daughter, guru and shishya, and spiritual seekers. Together, they served us with Divya Gnana Sudha. Dr. Alakananda, thank you immensely for your deeply researched, insightful lecture. And we would like to call upon Dr. Sriyamurthy to join us again in front of the camera. Bharatanatya is said to have been created by Brahma, combining all four Vedas, and it is hailed as Panchama Veda. And today, you personified the Panchama Veda for us, Dr. Sriyamurthy, through your demonstration. Thank you immensely. I have to thank Dr. Alakananda for being the fountainhead of Gnanasudha itself. It is your concept, your idea that has been giving us month after month these Gnanasudha satsangas. At this point, I would like to thank our elders at SVBF, our chairman, Dr. Lucky Lakshmanan, Dr. Parambat, for making these kind of events possible and then giving us opportunities time and again to participate and then increase whatever kinship we can of the Jnana and the spirituality and the bhakti. Also, I thank all our online viewers and our participants and our devotees who have been the backbone of all the programs and events at SVBF. You give us the energy and purpose to bring such events as today's event, today's satsanga, to everybody to enjoy. Without you, these events will not be possible. Thank you so very much for joining us. These Gnanasudha events are made possible by also the participation of volunteers who consider it a privilege to be part of such a journey, such a spiritual journey. Doctor, I would like to thank Kishore Nath, Shri Ram Ganeshan, Ganni Muralidhar, Ravi Shankar, Bindu and Sunil, Shrikant, Gopinath. There are many, many more. I may forget their names, but we cannot forget the contribution they make for Gnanasudha to happen every month. It's been a beautiful journey for all of us together, isn't it? And I would like to also before concluding today's program, I would like to invite you all to mark your calendar for next month's event. That will be by Padma Bhushan, Dr. M.B. Atreya. He will be speaking on Grihasthashrama in modern times. Don't we need to hear it? And at this point, I would like to request our priests and Sharda Bhat to please come and honor today's artists, Dr. Alakananda and Dr. Sriyamurthy.
वनमाली गदीशांगी शंकी चक्री च नंदकी श्रीमान नारायणो विष्णु वासुदेवो भिरक्षतु। ओम सुमंगलीरियं वधूरिमागं समेत पश्यत सौभा आज्ञमस्यै दत्त्वा जाथास्तं विपरेतन इमां त्वमीड्वसु पुत्रागं सुभगा आंग्रुणो दशा आस्यापतिमेकादशं कृति रोचनो रोचमानशोभनशोभमानः कल्याणः।
We conclude today's event by once again reminding you to please join us next month. The date will be announced closer to the third week of October. Again, the event will be, it's a lecture by Padma Bhushan, Dr. N.D. Atreya. He will be speaking on Grihasthashrama in modern times. Thank you for joining us. Shri Krishna Panamastu.